Having that perfect fairy tale ending to the interview question, tell me about a difficult situation, challenge, or conflict, and how you handled it, is sort of like saying, oh, I just work really hard when answering, what's your biggest weakness? Both answers seem a little too good to be true. Unfortunately, a lot of good candidates fall into the trap of thinking a flawless conflict resolution is all that's required to pass this question. But as soon as the interviewer follows up with additional question, that facade starts to crack and break because, let's be real, very rarely are workplace conflicts so cleanly resolved. In this video, I'll show you how having a less than ideal outcome can still make for a powerful answer, share how we can apply learnings from Nelson Mandela to this interview question, and provide a full sample answer at the very end. So let's get started. Hi friends, welcome back to the channel. If you're new here, my name is Jeff, and we're all about practical career and interview tips. So if you're a current student or working professional, consider subscribing for more actionable content. The key to coming up with a realistic and meaningful answer to the how did you handle a difficult situation interview question is to first understand that the interviewer is not looking for a perfect ending. Instead, you want to show number one, you are able to listen to and accept other people's point of views, even if you have already formed your own opinion. And number two, you're able to put the needs of the business above your own when a conflict does arise in the workplace. In a way, any outcome you end your answer with is simply a byproduct of how well you did those two things. Starting with the ability to hold your tongue and hear everyone else out. This is important because any hiring manager knows that workplace conflict is inevitable and in many cases necessary for a healthy team dynamic. I'll link a study published in the Harvard Business Review on that topic down below. And this is where the famous quote from Nelson Mandela comes in. Be the last one to speak. In a professional context, especially one where a conflict is involved, good managers know that letting the other person feel heard is half the battle, even if that person's ideas are rejected in the end. So a core part of your answer to tell me a time you dealt with conflict on the job should involve some version of you asking the other party to expand on the reasons as to why they believe they are correct. Then you show that you fully understood their point of view by paraphrasing the answer and repeating it back to them. This tells the interviewer you have generally tried to put yourself in their shoes. This part of your answer should fall under the action category of your overall structure, which we'll come back to in a little bit. By the way, please let me know down in the comments if you're getting value from this video so far. And while down there, make sure to click that like button 3 times as it would mean the world to me. Moving on to putting the needs of the business above your own. This part is more self-explanatory. The hiring manager needs to know that they're hiring a team player who is willing to put aside personal differences for the sake of the organization. To put it bluntly, are you willing to let your pride take a hit to show that you can take the high road and be a professional? To convey this point effectively, you pinpoint the exact moment where all parties involved are at the most risk of losing face. Then show how you de-escalated the situation by providing a platform for everyone to step down on. Common best practices here include suggesting a cool-off period and revisiting the situation a day after, or even acknowledging the other direction or idea has more merits than your own and could potentially be a better solution. This part of your answer should be under the result category of your overall structure and should clearly show how the broader team or business benefited as a result of your actions. At this point, many of my regular viewers will know the answer structure I'm referring to. Yes, I am talking about our good old buddy, Carl. Context, action, results, and learnings. I've done a whole video on why Carl is a superior answer structure to the STAR method, so make sure to check that out if you haven't already. While context and learnings play a complementary role for this specific question, compared to the more important action and results pillars, there are several pro tips I can share here as well. The context part of your answer should mention a relevant conflict you might realistically face in the new role you're applying for. For example, if you're applying for a job in a technology company where the team structures are relatively flat, a meaningful conflict is how you try to influence others without authority and the challenges that you faced. For the learnings part, this is simply an opportunity for you to recap what you did, explain why it was a correct course of action in that instance, and what you would do in a similar situation next time. Putting all this together, here's your sample answer you can reference. Hopefully you'll be able to see that even though the result was less than perfect, it makes for a very convincing and meaningful answer. Okay, Jeff. Could you please tell me about a difficult work situation and how you handled it? Of course. So a few weeks ago, a colleague on another team approached me asking for my help. She had just developed a new training program for her clients, and she wanted to leverage some of the content my team had created. Usually this wouldn't be a problem, but we found out very quickly that because she had her own program landing page and we had ours, having the same content on both our platforms would have caused confusion for our users. Because there were clearly some synergies between our projects, we decided to sit down and have a brainstorming session to figure out how we can help her achieve her goals without completely changing our existing infrastructure. Over the course of 2 days, I asked her a series of questions that helped us map out the user journey for her clients and mine. She was actually surprised I took the time to do this because usually other team members would just tell her yes or no based on her initial proposal. Unfortunately, even after 2 days, we were unable to figure out a good solution without having to deprecate one of our landing pages. So we agreed to consult a manager who had experience in this area. The manager acknowledged this was a tricky situation, and after referencing a similar project that she's worked on in the past, she gave us a solution that involved directing some of my existing users to my colleague's platform that will only host more advanced content. While this meant less traffic to my colleague and myself in the short term, this was clearly beneficial to the end user, and we kept the same content from showing up on two different platforms. Looking back, while we did need to consult a manager for this particular situation, I was pretty proud of how we exhausted all our options before exploring alternatives. We learned a lot from that user mapping exercise, and we actually came up with new ideas during the brainstorm sessions. And it taught me that next time, it's probably smart to involve a third party with experience in that area, right from the beginning, to be more efficient. As you can see, the candidate, who is surprisingly handsome, did a good job on both 1 and 2. He first showed that he was open to hearing new perspectives, even if it meant extra work, and then was willing to suffer a short-term loss for the benefit of the client and business. If you're interviewing right now, feel free to check out my playlist on common interview questions and answers that I'll link right there, and make sure to subscribe if you haven't already. See you on the next video. In the meantime, have a great one.